Welcome to Winix Studio. Let's start making games.
Hi and welcome. Today we are going to start a new series of tutorial on visual scripting. So this will be a three-part tutorial. The first part will be seeing how you can get started with visual scripting in Unity. In the next part, we'll see what are the important components or important nodes that you can use in visual scripting. And in the third part, we'll be creating a complete game using visual scripting in Unity. So if you don't know, Unity acquired Bolt in 2020. Bolt was a visual scripting asset in Unity Asset Store. Unity acquired it. From Unity 2021, Bolt is repackaged as visual scripting inside the Unity editor. So if you're using a Unity editor that is after 2021, then you don't need to import any type of packages because visual scripting is imported by default. And if you're using a Unity editor which is older than 2021, that is 2020 or 2019, then you have to download a package called Bolt from Unity Asset Store and use that with your Unity editor. Initially, Bolt was not free, but after Unity acquired it, Bolt is made completely free. So if you're using an older version, just go to Unity Asset Store, download Bolt and import it. Now, there is one more visual scripting tool called Playmaker. Playmaker is a little different than Bolt, because Bolt is basically the visualization of C#. So every node that you find on Bolt will have an equivalent function or a class in C# script. Playmaker is basically made keeping non-programmers in mind. If you are just getting started with Unity and you want to make a game without coding, then Playmaker will be a better option than Unity's visual scripting. But if your goal is to basically learn C# ultimately, then visual scripting package of Unity is the best way to go. So if you're looking to download Playmaker, then you can use the link in description to get Playmaker from Unity Asset Store. Playmaker is not free, so you'll have to buy it from the Unity Asset Store. So that being said, let's see how to get started with visual scripting in Unity. By default, the visual scripting package is imported into all projects. If for some reason it's not imported, then you can go to Package Manager, make sure Unity Registry is selected, and search for visual scripting, and then you can just install it. Now to add the visual scripting graph to your game object, just select the game object and click on add component and search for script machine. Yeah, once you add script machine, you'll also see a component called variables added to it. So basically any variables that you create inside your visual graph will be added to these variables. You can see that there is a drop down here near the source, and if you select embedded, then this visual script can only be used with this game object. So if you want to use it in some other game object, then that is not possible. You will have to select it as a graph. So it's better to go with the graph so that you can use the same visual script in different game objects. Once you've selected graph, and if you don't have a graph already, you have to just click on new. Then let's just give it a name. We'll say test and then press enter. So you can see a new graph is created. So to edit the graph, you can just click on edit graph. So if you use Unity already, when you create a new script, Unity adds the start and the update function to the script. Similarly, when you create a new graph, Unity adds the start and the update functions to the graph. When you create the graph for the first time, Unity takes some time and loads all the node options. And once all the nodes are loaded, the graph editor will be displayed. So as you can see, there's the start and there's the update. It's very similar to the C# script. So we can basically decide what we're going to do inside the start and inside the update. Now on the left side, you can, whatever node you select, you will see the properties of the node. And if you want to make it into a coroutine, you can just select it and make it into a coroutine. This is the one major difference between using Unity's visual scripting and Playmaker. Because in Playmaker, you don't have to understand the concept of what a coroutine is, what is an array and all that. But in order to use the visual scripting graph of Unity, you must have the basic knowledge of what are classes, what are arrays, what are functions. So in a way, this is basically visualizing your script. So you just don't have to remember the syntax. So if we create a new variable here, let's create a new test variable by clicking on the plus sign. So we'll just type in test1 and click on the plus sign. So the type is null, we'll set the type to integer and the initial value to 0. So once you have a variable, you can just drag it into the workspace and place it wherever you want. So you have the test variable, and you can connect it to any node that you create. So you can just drag a line from here and say, and add a new node. So we'll just say debug.logMessage. Okay, so that's the message. We'll do that on start. So when the game starts, we'll debug log, and the value will be the value of test. So let's set the value to 10. And once that is done, you can just close the graph. So now we have our logic ready. So now if we go back to Unity Editor and play the game, there's a debug log message which says 10, which is equivalent to the value of the variable that we created inside. If you want to add a node, either you can just drag a connection from the existing node and then add it. So if the connection is attached to you and you want to remove it, you can press escape to remove it. Then you can select any node from the graph and press delete in your keyboard to delete it. And to add a new node, you can just right click and search for the node. So it totally depends on what node you want to add. So for example, we can just add a fixed update. So basically start is called once when the game object is created. Update is called every frame. That is, if your game is running at 60 FPS, then the update function will be called 60 times per second. And fixed update is dependent on physics. And the number of frames is basically fixed, and it depends on the physics iterations. That's it for getting started with visual scripting. In the next video, we'll be seeing what are the major nodes that you need to know, and we'll go through them one by one. Thank you and stay tuned.
Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share.